The Hawaiian Islands experience thousands of measured earthquakes every year. Shown here are only those earthquakes since 1960 with magnitude greater than 3. They are coded by color according to depth. These earthquakes originate in 3 predominant source regions. 2 of those are in the volcanoes or along the volcano ocean floor boundary. The third is deeper, in the crust and mantle. Shown first are those earthquakes associated with magma accumulation and movement beneath the volcanoes as the magma rises through the crust, breaking rock in the process. Changes of pressure and mass within the volcano create stress in adjacent areas, producing earthquakes on nearby faults and cracks. Second are earthquakes occurring on faults within the volcanic edifice and at the boundary between the volcano and the ocean floor beneath it. Along the Kauai'i fault zone on the Big Island, the Kilauea side has moved down relative to the Mauna Loa side. Along the Helenapali, the coastal block has dropped relative to the Kilauea block. Faults of this type are sometimes called normal faults and are driven by the weight of the volcanic island. Earthquakes occurring on these faults are generally smaller than magnitude 5 unless they trigger the underlying fault between the volcano and the old ocean floor. It is there, along the boundary between the ancient ocean floor and the overlying volcano, that the largest earthquakes in Hawaii's history have occurred. That interface lies 7 to 10 kilometers deep, or roughly 26,000 feet. Slip there produced the magnitude 7.9 Kau earthquake in 1868 and the magnitude 7.7 Kalapana earthquake in 1975. The third general source of earthquakes in Hawaii lies deeper, in the brittle mantle. Earthquakes there occur as the Pacific plate adjusts to changing loads and temperatures from the large volcanoes above. The magnitude 6.7 Kiholo Bay earthquake in 2006 is an example of a mantle earthquake, originating 29 kilometers below the surface. These deep earthquakes occur widely, though infrequently, among the other Hawaiian islands as well. Deep earthquakes are the likely suspect for 3 magnitude 6 or greater events that occurred around the islands of Molokai in 1870, Lanai in 1871, and Maui in 1938. From our knowledge of earthquake history in Hawaii, we can calculate the shaking or seismic hazard from future large earthquakes. Warm colors, seen mostly on the island of Hawaii, indicate the highest seismic hazard in the state, comparable to that along the San Andreas Fault Zone of California. Seismic hazard decreases northwestward along the Hawaiian Island chain, as shown by cooler colors, but it remains significant as far northwest as Oahu.